And so, fellow Starians, welcome today. It is Thursday, and this is Astara's Meditation and Mindfulness. We wanted to get the top of the tonkas here. We'll be talking about some of them later in Astara's Meditation and Mindfulness today. It is wonderful, a pleasure, and an honor to be with you here in the now. And if you are tuning in, good afternoon, good evening, good night, and good morning. And so today we will open with one of the Astarian affirmations found in the first degree. Great architect of the universe, may I be a channel through which the holy ones approach the world. May I be a center for the radiation of thy power. Teach me to travel light that I may better gain height. Break the bonds that bind. Teach me to give of myself entirely to thy service, to attune myself to thy will. Teach me to lay down the small personal life for the greater cosmic life, and to love with the love of God. And so, Astarians, here today, we will continue discussions of the Holy Nod, also known as the Blue Pearl and the Mental Permanent Seed Atom. So in Astara's Book of Life, Book Club on Mondays, Reverend Anthony has gone over the Mental Permanent Seed Atom and is located in the causal plane, which is the fifth dimension. And there is a mirror reflection on the terrestrial plane. And it's located in the center. The seed is located in the center in the pineal gland. We've gone over it here in Astara's Meditations and Mindfulness. If you were fortunate enough to join Headminister Toes yesterday on Wednesday in Astara's study group, he went over meditation on the Holy Nod, also known as meditation on the Blue Pearl, also known as meditation on the soul. And it's found in Judeo-Christian practices, Tibetan practices, Egyptian practices, the world over. And so today we will continue with meditation on the soul. We will continue to dive into the Holy Nod. If you're able to tune in during the Sunday sessions, we are still continuing with the meditation of the Holy Nod. We're continuing the explanation. We're continuing to expound upon the inner teachings of the Holy Nod. Erlene writes about the Holy Nod in the first degree, the second degree, where she goes into the various energy centers in the glandular system, which is called the endocrine system. She talks about it again in the with the pineal gland. She talks about it in the third degree and the fourth degree. I believe it's talked about in every single degree, either directly or indirectly. And one of the things we're doing here for you and for all Astarians the world over is to string together those topics which are spanned throughout 8 degrees and dozens of ancillary books that the Chinese wrote. We're here to string those together, to compile them, to be able to provide you teachings that you can implement, that you may practice, and that you may apply in your daily lives. The spiritual life is not a theory, it's a practical application of living, and we are here to help you in that application. That is our job, and that is what we are here to do. And so if I may be of service, you're welcome to reach out to me at any point, at any time, and I am happy to communicate with you. And so we'll invoke to the Astarian hierarchy, to the Supreme Beloved God, to the Divine Father, to the Divine Mother, to the Divine Friend, and to the Beloved God, the Master, Katumi, to Master Rama, to Master Zosar, to Master Christ, also known as the Christo, or E Sa Na. We thank you for your humble blessings. We humbly invoke, command, will, and decree with your priceless blessings and permissions, divine guidance, divine help, divine protection, with the divine light, the divine love, and the divine power. May we be instruments of thy teachings. May we be instruments of thy healings. May we be instruments of the divine. Om Tat Sat Om. Om Tat Sat Om. And so, good Astarians, remember that the Astarian hierarchy is ever with you. Front, back, left, right, above, below, the Astarian hierarchy and Christ are ever present. They're ever present within you and around you and flowing through you. And the practice of the Holy Nod will allow you to attune yourself to greater degrees to these great beings. These great beings which are beyond human evolution and which have been sent back down to help guide humanity, guide the planetary disciple, which is humanity. That is what we are. We collect humanity collectively as a planetary disciple evolving on this planet and the planetary logos. And they are here to guide the planetary disciple, to guide humanity back into the bosom of the divine. And so we will here focus on the Holy Nod. And so if you take a string, you take an imaginary invisible thread, and you go from here to here, this little bump right here, this is called the occipital protuberance, okay? This is the occipital protuberance. And if you go to the point between the eyebrows, this is the Agya, or the Ajna chakra, okay? This is the energy center. If you draw an imaginary line between these two points, you draw an imaginary line between these two points. Arlene says, take a thread and draw a thread from one end straight back through, pull it through till it's taut to the other. That is the center. That is where the pineal gland is located. But you may be saying, yes, but we're not on a two-dimensional plane, we're on a three-dimensional plane, which is true. So if you fold your ear over, and you take the apex, this is called the apex, the ear apex, when you float over, apex means like top, okay? Top of the hierarchy. So you have the apex of the ear here, and we have the apex of the ear here. And if you take a clear thread and you draw that thread from the apex of the ears, you draw it through. You draw the apex of the ears through, you will find the center. And if you have this thread from the apex of the ear to the apex of the ear, and you have this thread from the front Agnya to the back head chakra, where these intersect, this is the seat of the Holy Nod. This is the seat of the holies of holies, the seat of the Holy Nod. Okay. And so if you see the Holy Nod is represented, the reason I was moving the screen is you see the Holy Nod is represented, and it's represented here. We have here the physical permanent seed atom, which is an orangish hue. We have a greenish hue. We have here a pinkish reddish hue, which is a physical permanent seed atom. And if we go up higher, we have the Holy Nod, the mental permanent seed atom located in the causal realm. The mental permanent seed atom here is blue. I'll circle it. Right? So this is the Holy Nod. And the Holy Nod is located in the center of the pineal gland. And the pineal gland can be located, and the blue pearl, the Holy Nod, can be located by drawing that clear thread between the Ajna chakra, the Agya chakra, the back head, and the apex of the ears. We'll go over how to practically do that in a moment, okay? And so when the blue pearl becomes activated, when the holy knot becomes activated, you have here, right? Another blue circle. You have here a blue circle, okay? Representing an illumined crown chakra and an illumined blue pearl. And you have here this peacock feather blossoming down, and it's rooted here into the blue pearl. You see a note of the blue pearl here and how it goes straight up, and it goes straight up 1 foot above the head. And then here's a whole nother blossom, and this is a whole nother teaching. And so this is the Anatta Karana. This is the spiritual cord that comes down. And from that higher soul, we have silver cords that drop down. And we have these silver cords, they connect to the holy knob, the mental permanent seed atom, the emotional permanent seed atom, and the physical permanent seed atom. And those are represented by this pearl, physical permanent seed atom. I'm sorry, the emotional permanent seed atom and you can't see it here with this camera, but there is an orange one on this side as well as this side. And we have the third permanent seed atom here. Okay, so today we're going to focus on the blue permanent seed atom here. Okay, this is one of the kings, Lord Mahaguruji Meiling. Buddha Padma Sambhav Rinpoche was a reincarnation of the ancient kings, and he came down to spread the holy Dharma in the land of Tibet. Okay. He came down to marry the sutra and the tantra, which means he came down to marry the text with the practice. Okay. He came down to marry the text. Tantra means ritual, with the practice, with the ritual. Okay. And that's what we're doing here at Astara. We're marrying and merging and forming union between the theoretical in the books, Astara's Book of Life, here and here. And we are providing practical applications of these teachings. Welcome, welcome. And so what we want to do now is we want to take that thread. We want to take that thread from the Ajna chakra to the back head chakra. Close your eyes. Close your eyes. And mentally draw a translucent, clear thread between the front and the back. Draw it taut and find the center. Find the center. Good. This is the center line. Now we're going to take the apex of the ears. You can fold your ears if you want. Find the apex of the ears. I'm going to draw a clear translucent thread. The apex of the ear to the apex of the ear. Draw that translucent clear thread from the apex of the ear to the apex of the ear. Now find the point where these two threads intersect. Find the point where these two threads intersect and interlock. The meeting point of these threads is where the pineal gland is located. The meeting point of these two threads is the location of the pineal gland, is the location of the holy knot. Close your eyes. find the interlocking point of these two clear threads. Good. Good. More and more of you are finding it. Good, good. When you find this holy knot, your system should be more calm, more at ease. Eyes closed. Connect the tongue to the roof of the mouth. Connect the tongue to the roof of the mouth. Eyes closed. Be aware of this intersecting point. Be aware of this intersecting point. There is no hurry. There is no rush. There is no time. Simply become aware of the intersecting point. The holy knot. become aware of the holy knot. Draw a clear, translucent thread from the back head to the Ajna center. Draw a clear thread from the apex of the ear to the apex of the ear. The interlocking point is the location of the holy knot, the mental permanent seed atom. Find this interlocking point. Become aware of the holy knot. You may experience inner peace, inner calmness, inner tranquility. You may experience a cessation of thoughts, a cessation of emotion, a cessation of action. Become aware of the holy knot. Clairvoyant observation may include brilliant white light, brilliant blue light, brilliant gold light, the faintest of hues, the faintest of light. Beyond the darkness shineth the light. Become aware of the holy knot. become aware of the holy nod. Find the intersecting point between the two clear threads. When you locate the holy nod, the systems will become calm, and it could activate various clair faculties. Ma ni. Slowly, slowly come back to the body. Come back. Become aware of the navel. Become aware of the navel. Become aware of the navel. Be aware of the soles of the feet. Become aware of the soles of the feet. Be aware of the center of the earth. Go down. Down, down to the center of the earth. May the planetary logos be blessed. May the planetary logos be healed. May the planetary logos be regenerated. Rejuvenated, revitalized, replenished. May the planetary logos be blessed. May the planetary logos be healed. Blessings to the planetary logos. You may open your eyes. Move your hands, move your feet. And so, good Astarians, remember the Astarian hierarchy is ever with you. Kutumi is ever with you. Christ is ever present. Front, back, left, behind, above, and below. The more you open and activate the holy knot, the more attunement with the Astarian hierarchy, and the more the Astarian hierarchy may flow through you, the more the Astarian hierarchy may do through you. We love you. We thank you.